Right, if someone, I mean, I think we can imagine that if they went to, or if anyone out there goes to professionals that do this kind of work to build a site for them and all that kind of stuff, that there's going to be some serious money involved in it. Obviously,
Absolutely.
if you have Forge from Freedom and the other businesses that you run, you have the qualifications to do that. And at the same time, if you're doing this kind of work, you're also taking a loss by doing it. So I
Absolutely,
think,
yeah. My
yeah, I think
time,
those numbers make
and I have to
sense.
say here, and I have to say here, Hank, that my time, what my time is worth was made very clear right from the start of the agreement, okay? Right before we worked together, and I said, I'll do this for you, but this is what my time is worth, okay? And this is what I expect to see in return. So it wasn't like I came later and changed something or anything like that. But it appears that he didn't take that seriously, or it appears that it didn't register.
Okay, so let's just try to jump forward here and just not to get bogged down in that, right? Because there's a
Right.
lot of questions, comments that are coming up here. How did that all went wrong because you put forward a bill, or it went wrong before that?
No,
How did this stuff go
it went
wrong with you
wrong when I
guys?
approached them and said, you have to keep your end of the deal and start pushing, okay? Or pay our invoice. You know, I mean, I'm giving you a choice. I said, if you think your time is too valuable to you and you don't want to do this, pay our invoice, right? One way or another, we need to get rewarded for making your saving your business and making your business much better than what it was. And he freaked out in the beginning, and then he agreed that we would sit down. We agreed a date and time where we would sit down on Skype and just talk all this out and find a solution, right? And instead of attending our deal at the exact time when they were supposed to be on Skype, I get a call from their lawyer.
And what did the lawyer say?
The lawyer said that they're not going to talk to me, and they're not. Well, the lawyer said they're refusing to talk to me other than through him, okay? And that our no invoices are going to be paid until we sign an NDA.
Okay. So, I mean,
Disclosure.
my understanding of that, all right, is that if, let's say you're in a business relationship with someone, you forward them a bill, and their lawyer gets in touch with you, that says to me things went wrong. Did you know things had gone wrong before the lawyer got in touch with you,
I
or?
had no idea that it was like that. Like, I was shocked,
So, but you realized it once a lawyer got in touch with you, right?
right. Well, once I picked up the phone and I was told who he was and who he was representing, it was like it was like you sucker punched me, right? For a second, I had to pause for a second and think about what's going on. And I listened to what he had to say, and I said, "Look, I'm respectfully declining to sign anything because NDAs are not signed at the end of an agreement; they're signed at the beginning of an agreement." And also, I said, "What your client is doing is they're holding our invoice hostage until we sign this piece of paper."
So did you guys eventually work this whole thing out? Did you sign an NDA? Did they
We did
pay
not.
you?
We did
What?
not.
Okay, so you didn't sign an NDA.
We did not. We refused to sign the NDA, and my response to that, they also locked us out of the website that same day. They locked us out of the very website that we built for them, out of the emails and all the marketing material and
What kind of
everything
stuff
else.
did you have access to for those guys?
The website, emails, marketing materials, that kind of stuff, you know. Contact with suppliers, most of which suppliers we had brought in, so it doesn't matter. I mean, I've still got contact with those suppliers. They're all good people, you know. But yeah, and we refused to sign the NDA, and my response to that, well, here's my invoice, and if you don't pay it, I'm just gonna follow business practice, send it to collections, okay? And if you don't pay it, then it's gonna go to court, and I'll take a lien on your business. All right? It's just normal business practice for me.
Do you think that you could go to that level with someone that you didn't have an actual written agreement with?
Go to what
In
you mean
terms
go
of now you get lawyers, you put a lien on them, etc.
yeah
Okay.
Yeah, not everything is bound only by contract. Okay, if you can prove that you've like okay, it's like getting a hailstorm, bringing in a roofer. Okay, he does the work for you, and you refuse to pay him for whatever reason. You don't normally sign a contract for those things, right? But you can prove that you did the work.
Right. Okay.
That's where the burden of proof falls. And if you can prove that you did the work, then you're good.
So whatever went down, you felt you had a valid claim
Right.
to make
Absolutely.
if they, if they wanted to do everything in a legit way.
Absolutely, yeah. And I
Okay.
have to say again that, look, for me, I would have preferred if they didn't do what they did and the way they did it. I would have preferred if we just had that Skype call, because I was not like, you got to pay my invoice. I was like, look, without disrespect, you either sit down and make an effort to give us our marketing, hold up your end of the deal, or you pay me for my time, because it's not fair that I've tripled your business and you've done nothing for mine.
Well, okay. And the flip side of that is also, I don't care how big of a YouTube channel you are, if someone's billing you at like, $75,000, that's a lot of money.
Right.
Yeah. So, I mean, I could see from anyone's point of view, if someone bills me, I'm like, what? And I don't generate anywhere near that kind of income. I probably spend a lot of money like
Right.
that, but I don't generate it. So, okay, what
It's
happened with
all
yours?
relative, Hank, because if $73,000 compared to half a million or of turnover is not really a lot of money.
Right, it's a business expense. So what happened with you guys? Did you guys settle this out in any way, or that got left as an open situation? Something
Well, no, it did
happened,
not.
I'm assuming, because you came out and made a statement that did where you didn't say any of this stuff.
Right. Yeah, I made a
Okay.
statement to say that our relationship ended. I mean, the minute that we found out that we got the call from the lawyer and they locked us out of the site and everything, I was like, I just want his stuff off my site. I don't want to be associated with him.
Okay.
It went down like that. In the end, we settled for a fraction of that money. We sold, like we lost a lot of money on that deal in the end.
Right. I think you did you say it in your statement here? I think
Yeah,
you
it was like
did.
$12,000 or
Okay.
something, right?
Right.
Because I just got tired of the back and forth. I got tired of the whole situation. It left a bad taste in my mouth. He paid me what he could allegedly afford to pay me, right?
Right.
And
So when you took that money, when you took that payment, did you guys have an agreement when you took that payment?
right. Our agreement was that we're going to leave each other alone. We're going to go
Okay.
our separate ways,
Okay.
okay? But like I said, afterwards, I found out that we were being defamed, okay? So, and it was confirmed to me with evidence. Now, I don't want to burn the people who gave me that evidence. I made it very clear I'm not going to burn them,
Okay.
right? But it is what it is, right?
So
We are
okay,
what.
so okay, so you guys, you took a payment from them. I'm sure that they still said to you, "Hey, we want an NDA." Did you sign an NDA, or did you refuse to sign an NDA? What
We
happened
refused
there?
to sign any paperwork. We did
Okay.
not sign anything.
Okay, you didn't sign anything, but you're saying you also told them that you would leave this alone, or what did you say?
Correct. Yeah. That was the agreement. We would both leave it alone. Okay?
Okay.
Just
All
go our
right.
separate ways and do our separate thing, right? But when they didn't keep that end of the deal either, okay, that's when I said enough is enough.
Okay, so like you're obviously you don't want to disclose who that was, but through someone told you, someone came to you and showed you evidence that somehow these
Common
guys were saying stuff about you.
friends. Yeah, common friends.
Okay. And that's what led to you deciding to put all of this out here.
Well, that and like in the beginning of the chat, we talked about me getting triggered by his response on your Instagram.